With the global semiconductor market hit in October, have you ever wondered what ASML must have done to boost its shares in a few weeks? Looking fearless and defying the odds of losing a major market player in China following the US sanctions? And how are its competitors faring? Especially TMSC? Well, stay with us and get to know what's new in the business world of the semiconductor industry. The global market of the semiconductor industry was valued at over $400 billion in 2021, and with a valuation of $300 billion more expected by 2028, it does say a lot about this industry. As you know, in this industry, production isn't the only instrumental factor but innovation as well. It is no secret that semiconductor manufacturing and design companies continue to battle each other out for dominance in their ever-growing technological advancement. Whether you are the one increasing acquisition activities to establish a stronger foothold in emerging technologies or making semiconductor investments, it makes no difference whether it is chip manufacturer or design. The major goal is to create vertical integration of their product cycle, increasing control over their supply chain, and depending less on other parties to remain competitive. When you look at 2024 and 2025, the demand drivers are definitely going beyond smartphones, cloud infrastructure, and so much more, even beyond the emergence of the electronic vehicle structures that are beginning to materialize. ASML also looks to expand beyond its localization, increasing its features, advantages, and benefits, building more infrastructure outside of the China-Taiwan region, which should be ready by early 2024. This move is also made to reach the high demand for its EU versus since 2018 and the post-pandemic. When you look at the primary drivers of ASML's dramatic boost, you can point out an increase in fab competition, an increase in market capitalization or its research advancements, or even the fact that EVs expected to become a leading demand driver. Even the competition sought by the company's top three customers, Intel, TSMC, and Samsung, plays a role in getting its products. But it hasn't been all rosy for the company. All of ASML's ecosystem had been rocked by the restrictions on selling high-tech EUV conductors to China from both the United States and Netherlands governments. This beat led to a steep fall in the stock price, following the fears of expected turns downs of 16% of its market and revenue generation found in China alone following the ban. Even as ASML Chief Executive Officer Peter Wennink admitted, all bans limited its system shipments in 2023, saying it was only selling DUV systems in China. Irrespective of the setback, ASML has most surprisingly given a solid report which seems to allay those fears, in the meantime at least. Following its third quarter, ASML reported €5.8 billion in sales, up 10.2% over the previous year, while its earnings per share came in at €4.39. It was a positive outcome for the company for several reasons. First, the company suffered severe supply constraints in 2022, as its revenue growth has been forecasted to have been higher, if not for the setback. Also, it had cuts in capital expenditure earlier, as some of its customers pushed back their expected dates to receive their machines. Something to worry about two Fitbit's competitors, as everyone in the industry did the same. While Chief Financial Officer Roger Dassen says softening demand is within the current backlog as the lion's share of its customers still wants their machines as quickly as possible. But maybe a significant factor here is ASML's monopoly on the semiconductor industry as the world's largest supplier and the sole supplier in the world of EUV photolithography machines, about 46% of global sales. The following month, though, was November 2022, during its investor meeting. Things would turn around as ASML announced it would be adding new manufacturing facilities to meet demand, and even if new manufacturing facilities aren't built in China, they would need to be built somewhere else to satisfy the market's growing demand for new chips, as it looked to expand beyond China. By doing so, it took aside China and its concerns. As its stock prices rise during the week and month of its investors' meeting, the company also expects to kick off its shipments of next-gen high-end EUV systems, which will enable its customers to produce even more minor chips, in 2023 to ramp up its production capacity to 20 systems a year by 2027 to 2028. Irrespective of the market conditions, ASML's EUVs are geared toward the most leading-edge logic chips you have ever seen in the world. It didn't just spend 15 years of its time researching prior to its big break in 2010 when it first shipped its first prototype extreme ultraviolet lithography tool to an Asian research facility chipmaker, signaling the beginning of a new era in lithography. And more than a decade later, its competitors are still struggling to catch up with it, on the leading edge as it transitions to the newest points every year. Following the October 7th sanctions by the United States government on China, prohibiting the sale of chips from U.S. semiconductor materials from U.S. semiconductor companies and its affiliates, the semiconductor industry as a whole saw a fall in stocks, not even the big guns like TSMC were spared. TSMC is the world's most valuable semiconductor company and the largest dedicated independent semiconductor foundry in the world. For the Taiwanese multinational semiconductor manufacturing and design company, situated at the industrial heart of Hsinchu in the Hsinchu Science Park, home to over 360 high-tech companies. The city is one of Taiwan's most populous cities in the northwestern Taiwan province. TSMC has the leading semiconductor foundry in the world with a market share of 53.6%, with its closest rival Samsung Electronics at just 16%, providing semiconductors for Apple, AMD, Qualcomm, MediaTek, and lots more. TSMC is the largest dedicated independent semiconductor foundry in the world, while ASML is the sole supplier in the world of extreme ultraviolet lithography photolithography machines and the largest supplier in the semiconductor industry. That is a big difference. TSMC is believed to have the most advanced processing technology for chip fabrication, but both boaters do similar things within the industry. TSMC has a majority of its shares owned by foreign investors. On October 11, 2022, the stock price of TSMC shares plummeted by more than 8% in a single day. The largest single-day drop in its 28-year history. The general market conditions in the semiconductor industry have become sluggish and slow in demand, especially from China during that period. TSMC's largest market is still the United States, with the Taiwan market as its second largest market. A large part of TSMC revenue generation is made from the expenses of US companies like Apple. The Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing Company, TSMC, slashed its capital spending by up to 18% for this year to $36 billion, as it's spending capital by 10% this year, citing part equipment delays and sluggish demand as its reason. Its swift response to weakness in medium-term demand outlook, alongside other semiconductor giants, was tightening its capital spending budget for this year, it said. Also, adding that it would be more conservative about new capacity planning next year, as market demand had emerged so weak that there is a chance for further business correction could take place next quarter. Like most companies, TMSC couldn't do much at that point following the ban, which was worrisome considering that ASML seemed to have had it all figured out in weeks. If TMSC continues to fold its arm and do little or nothing about its current situation, it will surely regret it. However, a turnaround event for the company would occur shortly following ASML's remarkable recovery. A ray of hope would appear on a positive note, as the Oracle of Omaha Warren Buffett, Berkshire Hathaway, thought it fitting to buy shares worth a $4.1 billion stake in the Taiwan-based company, giving the company a large shot. The company saw its shares move up 10% on November 15 after the news emerged that the company of the man fondly called America's greatest investor bought it. This move brought respite to beleaguered TSMC investors, who have witnessed a 38% drop in the stock's value in 2022 despite a string of impressive quarterly results. The truth is there is still a lot of working and catching up to do. And no one knows how it would entirely go for these big semiconductor industries following the loss of a major market. One thing is to show the journey is long and tough, but the will to expand, innovate and stay on top would say a lot about them in the coming years, as there is definitely gold at the top and a larger market to explain even beyond China, pending the time at which tensions between the United States and China may be eased a little or better still, lifted up. We're sure you enjoyed this video, so make sure you like and comment on this video. Remember to subscribe to our channel and turn on notifications so you don't miss our other videos.